now. He was, no doubt, one of the most gifted student athletes of all time. Talking about Terps legend Len Bias, headed to a promising career in pro basketball when he died. It's been nearly 33 years. That cardiac arrhythmia brought on by a cocaine overdose. The University of Maryland and sports fans everywhere just stunned by the loss. Athletes who played for the Terps after Len Bias' death struggled to regain their passion for the game. It impacted not just players, but some of the Terps' legendary coaches as well. Well, two Maryland alums, legends in their very own right, out with a book now called Lessons from Lenny, The Journey Beyond a Shooting Star. They need no introduction, but we'll give it to them anyway. Walt Williams and Tony Massenburg join us now. It's great to see both of you guys this morning. The book is just out. It's coming out now. Here's the cover of it, Lessons from Lenny. I want to start at the beginning, though, with you guys, because before you even went to Maryland, you grew up here. You grew up in Virginia. What did Len Bias mean to you guys?
Well, I know Len Bias meant everything to me. My dad had took me to a Maryland game. And so before that, I was a Hoya fan. And so then I got a chance to see Len Bias in person. And then I was a forever Terp fan from that moment on. And so he had an immediate impact on me. And then to learn that he's from Prince George's County, the same place I'm from. And so it was even more intriguing for me.
You grew up a little further away from D.C., but what impact did he have on you wanting to come to Maryland?
Well, he's just my favorite player. I mean, I grew up in Southern Virginia where mostly everybody's Virginia Tech and UVA, and we're close to the part of Virginia I grew up in is close to North Carolina, so a lot of people are Carolina fans also, but I was the only Maryland fan in my area, and I really fell in love with the way he played the game. That inspired me. And so for me, wanting to go to the University of Maryland ever since I was literally in like ninth or 10th grade, rather, and to be recruited by Lefty Gizelle, I couldn't pass it up. I wanted to go play 1 year with Lenny and be able to learn from him because I wanted to be just like Lenny as a basketball player.
And in that year, what did you learn?
In that year, I learned about the work ethic that Len Bias put in. A lot of people don't understand that, like, he wasn't just a gifted athlete. He worked really, really hard. And I learned the things that he did to make him as good as he did as far as training in the weight room, drills, and just basketball in general, and playing for Coach Lefty Gizelle, who, again, probably been one of Lenny's biggest fans. He always encouraged us to be like Lenny.
I think for the two of you, you were very invested in Lenny's story from a younger age. This was your passion, and this would turn out to be your career path. For many others of us who were on the periphery, who just enjoyed watching him play and basketball as a sport, I think what really attracted people to the story of Len was because there was such a rapid rise and such a quick fall. And that always provides a great storyline. Unfortunately for Lenny, it was the tragedy of losing his life. How did that impact you at the time?
Well, I think Lefty said it best. You know, one mistake doesn't wipe out a lifetime of excellence. I mean, Lenny had like I mentioned earlier, he had a direct impact, immediate impact on me, our community. And so one narrative is about the circumstances surrounding his tragic death. But another narrative is the impact that he had on me, the impact he had on Tony, the community, the University of Maryland as a whole. And so with some positive impacts that he had before his death and after, and that's what we wanted to touch upon.
And I want to get to that in a second, but Tony, for you, you were playing with him at the time. Mm-hmm. When you first heard that your hero died, what did you think?
I was in the emergency room along with my teammates, and we were obviously devastated. I mean, we were there, and his mom comes out, and she tells us that he's gone. And it was just a life-altering moment for all of us. But his mother, to me, made the most powerful statement of all when she said that Len Bias touched more people in death than he ever could have in life. And the things that I learned going through the aftermath of his death at the University of Maryland are the things that helped shape me and made me want to come back to the University of Maryland once I went to the NBA and help the program get back to prominence.
And I think she was spot on that revelation. And shout out to Len's mom, who is still around and
yes, she is.
Still in the area right now. What was it, though? Because it had to be tough, especially Walt, you come in now to this program where now you have a different national spotlight on
Absolutely.
The program. And you have to, first of all, decide, I still want to do this.
Yes.
And second of all, take that and bring this program to a higher level? How do you do that?
Well, I personally wanted to do that. You know, these kids in this environment nowadays, they have aspirations of being an NBA player. For me, I never even thought about that. The thing that I wanted to do is we would go out on the playground and play basketball, and we all would pretend like we were Len Bias. And so that was the thing for me. I wanted to follow in his footsteps. I wanted my community, when the kids played on the playground, I wanted them to pretend like they were me. You know, and so that was part of my inspiration, part of my push to want to be at Maryland. And I just wanted to bring the university back to prominence. I felt like I had a great idea of what my experience would be there. And then all of a sudden, when the Len Bias tragedy happened, it was sort of a black cloud on the university. And I knew that it was some glorious things about the university that I wanted to bring to the forefront. So I felt like it was important for me to continue my journey.
Tony, leave us with something positive here. You had a chance, obviously, to learn from him for some time. What was something that you took away from Len, whether it be his being or his work ethic or his skill set, that I think we all can learn from, even though his life ended decades ago now?
I think the biggest lesson that I learned is that, first of all, life is not guaranteed. And for Lenny, during the time that I was around him, I developed a killer instinct. That's what I took from him. And Lenny's thing was, you know, we are Maryland, and you wear that jersey with pride, and you go out when you're on the court, you play your best and you play your hardest and you play with heart. And those are things that I took from Len Bias. The reason why I came to Maryland was to learn some of these things and try to figure out, why is Len Bias so good? What does he do? I gotta know. And so for me to get that year with him and to be around him and to experience his work ethic, his overall aura, he was the first real superstar that I'd ever been around. And just all of that rubbed off on me, and it really helped me through my journey through the NBA.
Len is long gone, but the program rebounded nicely with the national championship. The two of you spent decades in the NBA. I highly recommend the book. It is called Lessons from Lenny. You can go out and pick it up now. Walt, Tony, thanks, guys. Appreciate you joining us this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Best wishes to you guys as
well.
Tuck, we'll send it over to you. Good morning. Steve, great interview. All right, 32 now in Washington.